Welcome to class, students. In this class, we'll take one example and we synthesize our code and we try to understand how the text code written in Verilog is converted to a gate level network. So you select new project. So assuming that we are writing half adder code. Here device, there are many devices available, Spartan 3, Spartan 6, Vertex, CPLD, FPGAs. In that Spartan 3 we have selected. In that Spartan 3 there are many target devices, so assuming that we have selected 3S50, package PQ, plastic quad, 208, total pins are 208 IO pins. Speed grade, it's 5 nanosecond, pin to pin delay 5 nanosecond, so that is indicated as -5. Simulator, we have selected iSIM, synthesis tool XST, which supports VHDL as well as Verilog. Next, once the device selection is over, so device selection and dumping the code onto this target device, we say it as technology mapping. Technology mapping means it is with respect to a particular device that we have selected out of many possible devices available. With the tool we can program a number of target devices. So in that one device we have selected, with respect to that we need to convert our text code written to gate level network and then finally implement on that. So you select a new source. We are writing Verilog module for half adder. So half adder, A, B are the input, sum and C out are the outputs. Size is 1 bit. Size is 1 bit. Assuming that we have written code using a data flow style of description, A XOR B. Now here we have to select implementation part. What I have shown in previous videos is simulation. Simulation is different thing, synthesis is different thing. Simulated code, we cannot guarantee that it is always synthesizable. For example, timing delays included in simulation are not taken care in case of implementation, that is in logic synthesis. Delays are neglected or ignored. So for simulation, already you know, select simulation, select file, behavioral check syntax, and click on simulate behavioral model. So here by assigning values to A, B, we can observe the values of so here you can observe when 1 1 AB, sum is 0, carry out or carry is 1. So we are getting output. Like this, you can go for all remaining combination and check the output functionality. This is known as functional verification. We can say functional verification we have done with the help of simulation. And when you select implementation part for the same code, when you want to implement on target device Spartan 3, Xilinx Corporation, Spartan 350, pin configuration PQ208, delay is 5 nanosecond. If you select a particular target device, and according to that you need to convert your design to gate level network and then schematic, technology schematic. So we see those steps. So in tool you have got option to create timing constraints, floor plan or area, that constraint also we can put. So area, timing and power, these constraints can be put for code. Then in synthesize option you can go for check syntax, you can click view RTL schematic. So by synthesize step, what we are doing is the text code written is converted to it is understood by the tool and it is converted to gate level network. So it has understood half adder, ports A, B and sum and C out are the two ports, output ports, input and output ports it has identified. This we can call it as symbol. So input and output ports are understood by your tool. Now next step, synthesis means, logic synthesis means, from HDL Verilog code we need to see how it is understood or how it converts to gate level network. Earlier it is done manually, now it is done with the help of synthesis tool. I can see fit to window. So assume you can see here a carry logic is implemented with the help of two input AND gate, and XOR how it is implemented if you want to see. So it is again implemented with the help of NOT gate, AND gate and OR gate. So XOR gate is implemented like this in the tool. So this itself is known as the process of converting from Verilog code to a gate level network is known as logic synthesis. Earlier it is done manually, now we are doing with the help of a tool, a CAD tools. So in this example we are using a Xilinx synthesis tool. Now next step is we can also observe technology schematic. So technology schematic refers to how many lookup tables. So internal architecture of FPGA contains lookup tables and IO blocks. So here it has used two blocks. One lookup table implements AND gate. One more lookup table, it implements XOR operation. It implements XOR operation with the help of NOT gate, AND gate and OR gates. So two AND gates, two NOT gates and one OR gate, two input OR gate is used to implement sum and carry out. So this is done. So in synthesize step, first step is convert Verilog code to a gate level network, and then with respect to particular technology, that is with respect to target device which we have selected, 3S50 5PQ. So with respect to that it has used two lookup tables. We can also see design summary, synthesis messages. So number of four input LUTs used are 2, number of IO blocks used are 4 because our design has got two inputs and two outputs. For input as well as output including, we need IO blocks, 4 IO blocks and 2 4 input LUTs our design has included. Apart from that, what I want to show here is translate means an unoptimized gate level network is designed here. So translate, map, then place and route. In place and route you can see in translate map out of 1536 LUTs available and 124 IO blocks available, so you need to select, your design need to select only 2 LUTs and 4 IO blocks. Based on the pin user constraint file, that pin configuration that we select, okay, all pins can act as input and output. IOB means input output blocks, LUT means lookup tables. Okay, so here in this design it requires 2 LUTs and 4 IO blocks. It selects such a way that delay is minimum, so our timing constraints are met. So configure device, here the final programmable file is generated when I click on configure target device, and that file we need to dump on target environment, so that final chip that on FPGA or CPLD that we have implemented, it behaves like a 1-bit half adder. Similar to your logic design lab, here you can give inputs and outputs by changing switches. Okay, VCC for logic 1, ground for logic 0, like that. You can vary inputs and you can observe output on LEDs. Off means logic 0, on means LED on means logic 1, like that. We can verify with the help of target device. Now here, this is an effort. I have made an effort to understand the theory part that we have discussed, like functional verification, logic synthesis, technology mapping. Technology mapping means with respect to particular target device. Then all these place and route means select actually LUTs and IO blocks. Route means connect those IO blocks and LUTs. So programmable connections includes muxes, and your final file will contain programmable value 0 and 1 bit file, so that you can program FPGA to behave like half adder. So this is how the process is. Simulation is different thing, implementation is different thing. Simulation is functional verification, implementation means you have to dump your design on target device. Okay, hope you got some idea, you understood. We'll continue in next class.